This is our art piece, 3D printed on Prusa. Sorry, I don't know if I'm allowed to swear on your channel.
I dropped mine down the stairs and it just kept on printing. It's a beautiful thing.
Hello, Prusa fans. We are here at the Linus Tech Tips headquarters where we make 20-ish videos a week across 9-10 sets. I have lost count of both of them because there is so much to show you and also show you how we integrate 3D printing into all of it. There's so much to cover that let's do it. Our first set is the short circuit set. It is awesome because you can set up here one person, they sit down. We already have three cameras on the go. Hit film on all of them and you are set to film a video right here. Coming along this way, we have Costume Land, the not so good one. So say that you don't have an LTTstore.com shirt on, you can come in right here and be like, oh, actually I want this one with the cool stuff. And oh, we have a V-neck of it as well now. On LTTstore.com, like I said. Here we have Terran's CEO chair, which for whatever reason, he did not want to keep in his office. I cannot believe it. Over here, we have the WAN show set. This is where we do our Friday live streams.
Welcome, welcome, one and all. Yeah. All of you, even you.
Oh.
Now we're going into the main set area, but as this sign says, they're about to start shooting, so
we have to be kind of quiet. Moving in here, we have the tech link set on the left, build corner on the right. Beyond that, we have the editors, and we also have this absolutely massive green screen. We actually have a better one upstairs, but this one's still really useful because it has the whole green floor as well. You can guess what this door number used to say, but we had to change it for sponsor reasons. Moving in here. They are actively filming a video, which is why we are whispering. They have this really cool super directional speaker that they are using.
We have a 3D printed screwdriver.
They're doing us after Boeing. Or before Boeing?
Before Boeing.
I believe the end cap was yeah.
All the orange parts, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I don't have a mic. Cool. Okay, I'll start over. This is a 3D printed version of our screwdriver. It's done at, I believe, 4X scale.
Three,
thank you. Anyway, it's hanging here because we're doing a video on this directional speaker, which is more for like art installations, museums, showrooms, and I'm gonna walk up and I'm gonna be all a discerning person who wants to learn about this thing. And what's gonna happen is as soon as I step into exactly the audio beam that this thing sends at me, I'm gonna be able to hear it. And as soon as I step out of it, I'm not gonna be able to hear it. But yeah, this is our art piece, 3D printed on Prusa. Sorry, I don't know if I'm allowed to swear on your channel.
They can bleep.
Yeah.
Oh, it's good. Perfect.
Moving over here, we have our camera land. We have a bunch of lenses, bunch of easy rigs. We have a bunch of cameras. I was told to be quiet, and all of the charging as well. I really like using the Delta for all of our automotive content. We just ratchet strap it to the back of our F-150, and that's how we get the cool rolling shots. Over here we have our large item short circuit set, as well as lots of B-roll and stuff is shot in here. Speaking of B-roll, this is our B-roll area, so we do shots right there. We have the item on the glass table, then the TV bounces off of it, it looks sweet. And you can see them doing CPU super close-ups right over there. Behind the B-roll we have our prop land. We have an anatomically correct skeleton, and it's incredible how much production value just adding a horn or something like that to your video can do. And in here we have our editing den, as you can see. Not all of the editors are here because some of them edit from home, which is really just as good for the most part. There's a lot of people in here. Hi, Oliver.
Hello.
These are the guys from Prusa.
Oh, hey.
We're doing a quick factory tour. Well, not a factory, but you know. And moving upstairs, our first stop is going to be in Disneyland. This is where they handle all of the getting us sponsors and HR and thumbnails and stuff like that. Are we allowed to show this board?
I don't know.
Probably not. Maybe blur that board. In here we have people like Colton doing things like not working a whole lot at the moment.
Hey, what's
What's up?
Moving into here, we have our accounting department. There's not a whole lot going on besides more HR, but moving into this spot. In this meeting room, we have all of our play buttons. This is the best spot to take a conference call. You sit right here, have the backdrop of all of your play buttons, and you just feel very swag, especially with this one right here. Look at, oh, this thing is made out of nickel and it is heavy. And moving into here, we have our news team and also Sammy. He doesn't do news. I actually don't know why he's over here. The thing that's really cool about our news team is that we have this ultimat here. So you can see that Riley is automatically keyed in hardware so that it just goes straight to our editors like that. They don't have to worry about any of it. And he right there is just in front of green. There's actually no set. It's completely a lie.
I wasn't doing the dances. The dance is just, that's in the computer. Hi,
I'm Tynan Stack. I'm a senior mechanical engineer and shop supervisor here at LTT. And we're in our LTT Labs building. Behind me, you can see our labs desks, a bunch of our workstations, some of our test chambers, like our anechoic chamber and our electromagnetic test chamber, and then a lot of our storage and logistics areas. So coming over here, we can see we have a couple of test benches, a nice workstation with a bunch of labeling and setups, and our keyboard tester, which is one of our more 3D printed pieces of equipment. We have a LiDAR scanner that has a 3D printed mounting bracket, as well as a force test setup for the actual actuator measurement. We have some more test benches, a whole bunch of keyboards to be tested. And this isn't currently in deployment, but this is our high-speed mouse tester that allows us to test well beyond what any human could do, and some nice 3D printed fixturing for it as well. And here we have our earliest prototype of our mouse tester, which was designed by Kyle, our engineering manager. Keyboard latency tester, a nice 3D scanning setup for bringing in models and sharing with other people on our website, lttlabs.com. A drag force tester. And one of our more fun toys, our industrial CT scanner from Lumafield. Here we have our electromagnetic test chamber from Raymond DNC, which allows us to test 5G and Wi-Fi performance of phones and other devices.
This is probably going to be more B-roll, but...
This one we can't go inside, but... And close her up. Nice tight seal to keep all of those electromagnetic waves out and in. In here, we have all of our prototyping tools, evaluation equipment, everything from our optical measurement system, our wall of FDM 3D printers, an SLA system, and our Fuse One Plus SLS printer. At Creator Warehouse, we design, develop, and work with manufacturers to make our consumer products for LTTstore.com. So that means I get to work on things like our screwdriver, and other tools and other things that we're working on in the background. We use all of our 3D printers and prototyping tools to enable us to get closer to a final product before we send anything to an actual manufacturer to get molds made. 3D printers are incredibly integrated into our workflow and a key part of it. When we added more 3D printers to our portfolio, it allowed us to make better and better parts that were closer and closer to the final products we were going to receive from our manufacturers, which helped us reduce the amount of time we needed to get a product launched. Our workflow generally starts on the FDM printers, as they are the lowest barrier to entry to get a part that you can use and kind of get a feel for. After that, we move on to either our nylon SLS printer or sometimes our SLA printers to get either more resolution or properties that are more similar to the final parts we're gonna get. For us, the Prusa printers have a lot of reliability and give us flexibility to use more flexible materials, whereas some of the other systems we have struggle more with those. If we need to get something consistent across all of our machines, generally I'll personally go to one of the Prusa printers, as we have a little bit of consistency issues across machines for other brands. The Mark IV for me is a large quality of life improvement in terms of the automatic bed leveling, the input shaper to greatly increase speed, and the extrusion system, which allows us to print a wider variety of materials more consistently. I think if you don't have a 3D printer in your shop or you're doing design or manufacturing, you're missing out on a valuable step in a process. It allows you to make cheaper prototypes faster and prove out designs before you go and make them at scale. I've had a lot of experience with 3D printers all the way back to when I started university. And for me, it was pretty easy to get started. Even back then, things were design your part, put it through a slicer, which was more work then, and toss it on your printer to get a part in a few hours. And it's only gotten easier since then. Linus will randomly show up, say, hey, I need to make this thing. And sometimes he'll just hand it to us to do, or sometimes he'll ask, hey, teach me how to use the thing so I can use it down the road. But yeah, he randomly shows up and prints things fairly regularly.
Our first time working with Prusa though was all the way back in 2020. We got something in like 30 printers to build a massive sculpture or something like that. I don't even remember. It was 2020, so you can probably see where this was going. We had a bunch of printers arrive and suddenly everything got locked down and everybody needed face shields and medical equipment that was just not in supply at all. What we did was we now had all of these 3D printers and we needed to make face shields. So we had them assembled by a whole bunch of maker spaces around Vancouver. And we had them turn into a massive print farm so that we could print off just hundreds and hundreds of face shields. Now, we did that for a little bit and we did get some face shields into hospitals, but it turned out that it was a whole regulatory pain. We had to send them to Burnaby to get sanitized and then get sent out, and they weren't actually needed as much as we expected. But what we ended up doing is making a whole bunch of ear savers. These are little things that clip on the back of your mask, and it was so that the nurses could not have their ears just hurting so much. And we ended up making thousands and thousands of those. You might have noticed that around our sets, there's a whole bunch of blue filament. That's stuff that we got during that time, especially for making ear savers and stuff like that. We went through about half, a little bit over half of it in a month. The rest of it has lasted us nearly 4 years. After making several thousand of these ear savers and face shields, the orders started going from, we need a couple hundred, we need a couple thousand, to we need 100,000 or don't talk to us. And that's when we were like, industry's kicked in. We can start using our 3D printing farm for fun things again. My first experiences with 3D printing was back when I was an engineering student and we had a Fortis MC900, I believe, which is an absolute monster of a machine. I would 3D print so much stuff on that. My typical stuff as an engineering mechanical designer would be arrive, 3D print a model, do a revision in the afternoon because it was fast enough to get a revision, and then next morning come back in, have a new version of it, and be able to just do the whole process over again. Then I took probably a 4-year stint off of 3D printing because I arrived here and all of our 3D printers sucked. There is nothing worse than having a 12-hour print coming in the next day and it's ruined, especially when you have super duper tight shooting deadlines. What honestly changed it for me, this is not me shilling for Prusa, but we got a couple of these in and they just worked like the Fortis that I had used before, even though the Fortis was a $750,000 machine. These are not. And they are wonderful. I dropped mine down the stairs and it just kept on printing. It's a beautiful thing. The Prusa MK4, it's just the 3, but better. I don't know, it just works. It's the same story. The amount that I could not care if my 3D printer's a little bit faster is a lot compared to does part come off of it that works. My favorite thing about 3D printing has to be just the pure versatility. You can just think of the craziest geometry ever and you can just make it. You don't have to be thinking like, does a tool have to go down into this hole to make it? Or is this a two-dimensional thing? No, you can just do whatever you want. You can be a really lazy engineer and just 3D print it. It's beautiful.